morning, a good evening, and good afternoon. This is Nathaniel Kempton Productions here today, and welcome to the unboxing table. Now, we have a couple things to get through today. Hopefully, you are somewhat impressed by the overhead shot, and hopefully everything sounds decent as well. So, I have purchased myself a brand new camera, and we're going to open it and have a look at it today. I've also got some accessories for it, and the first thing is, I'm pretty sure it's some kind of carrying case, specifically for the type of camera, or the brand of camera rather. So there you go, you can see there. Sony, looking delightful. I should hold it towards me like that, so it's the correct way for you. So it looks fairly simple and straightforward. It's got a clippy open-y bit, which seems to also be a zip as well. Let me just see if I can break this tie thing on here. I'm not holding it in shot very well, am I? I do apologize. Right, there we go. And then unzip it. There we go. That seems fairly straightforward and quite cute. And the next thing, I'm pretty sure this is going to be the actual SD card. Now, I did choose to buy an SD card. I have plenty of them, but because the camera is a 4K camera, I wanted something a little bit more kind of beefy. So here we go. This is the one that I went with, a SanDisk 256GB one. There's the card, tucked away safely, and it's a little protective box thing, which I'll keep in the box. SanDisk Extreme Pro 256GB. Oh yeah, I hope that's in focus. I cannot tell. So, the main attraction itself. I may have to zoom out a little bit for this, so bear with me. Oh no, it's ruined the shot. You can see it's not straight along the back now. Oh, and a big shadow from the camera itself. I do apologize. So, for those who don't know, for the longest time, the camera that I'm using now, this camera, you, is actually a DSLR camera. It's a Canon 200D. Very good, I will admit. Absolutely no wrong with it. But because it is a picture-taking camera, primarily, that does mean that it is limited on how long in one go it can record for. Just some weird, I think it's, I want to say EU, but I don't think it is EU. I think it's just universal stupid laws that they have, that a video camera has more tax on it than a photographing camera, and blah, 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 boring, who cares? So, there it is. The Sony FDR AX43A. I don't know what that A part is about. Okay, so there you go. There is the information for you there. I won't read it because I'm sure you can read. It's fairly obvious, really, what all this stuff means. But while I am in a close-up shot, I will get a close-up view cutting the seal. Oh yeah. Right, let's zoom back out. Okie dokie then. So, let's yank this out. I'm quite excited for this. I'm less nervous opening this than I was the Acura Scale Mana Class, even though this was considerably more expensive than the Mana Class by quite some way. And I will talk about the price later on in the video, probably towards the end. So we just get some, this is boring paperwork by the look of things. Operating instructions, I might need to keep that handy. So remind me where it is. And here we go. The exciting part. So take a look. Accessories. Your standard kind of radio type plug. Nothing really special about it, although there is a barcode on it, which I guess could make it special. We have a couple of USB leads here. We have a one of those type connectors, which are hideous and should be done away with. Oh, okay. We have an HDMI cable, which is quite a nice touch, I guess. A normal HDMI to, you know, is that mini or is that micro HDMI? I forget. Doesn't matter. I think I've got one of these already somewhere. I don't know where, but I have one. And then we have, there we go then. So this plugs into the camera to charge it. And of course, that's where the
radio
lead goes in, just here. Like so, there you go, there's your charging. So don't even need to take out the battery to charge this sucker up. I'm very happy about that, because I hate having to take batteries out of cameras, because it's an absolute ruddy nightmare. Although, I believe you can take the battery out, should you want to, for whatever reason, if you need a spare one, or whatever. But let's take a look at the main attraction, shall we? Let's clear the shot as much as we can. The charging lead has decided to wants to be in shot now. Sorry. I was trying to be professional and then forgot to charge everything. Okay. There's no battery in the back of the camera. Hang on a second. There is a lump of cardboard in the back here, and I bet that is where the back. Oh, no, it's not. Oh! I was on the right track, but the wrong part of the box. Can you see in that bit there? You can probably see the label reflecting. There it is. Oh, that was a bit of a panic. There we go. So there's the battery. It's a battery. And it clicks in a little something like... wait a minute. That. So it looks like it's got a little bit of a tail, I suppose. But there we go. So that's the camera itself. Now, if you look at the lens, you can hopefully, there you go. You can see it's completely skew-whiff. That's fine. This camera, much like the camera that I'm using, the Canon, has image stabilization built in. So the actual lens of the camera is on a gimbal type thing. Although interestingly, the shutter should be across, theoretically. I have a little carry handle on the side, which is nice. It's a bit small for my massive hands, but there we go, I can figure that out. So I have easy access to the zoom. I think this has up to like 30 times zoom, or maybe 40 times zoom. I forget which one it is exactly. There we go. 30 times zoom in 4K and 40 times zoom in 1080p HD. That's quite impressive. At least I think it is anyway. So you can see at the top here, this little grill doodad is the 5.1, hopefully you can see, surround sound microphone built into the camera, which I'll be interested to listen to and kind of judge how it sounds in comparison with my external microphones. We have, what's that, a quarter inch, I think, or possibly an eighth inch, I don't remember, standard screw mount thing. If I'd have thought about it, I should have had a camera mounty plate thing handy, but I didn't think of that, but I'm sure it's the same. In terms of buttons, there's basically none, really. You've got the the record button on the back, that one, and then the zoom on the top, and the photograph button there for taking still photos if you're mad. We have a very cute little cubby hole. That's where your HDMI mini cable goes in, and also your external microphone. And also on this side at the front, behind this little cubby hole, hopefully you can see there, if I get it at the right angle, the little green headphone port for listening to your own audio. So I don't know if this battery is charged. I'm going to presume that it isn't, but I am going to open the screen and we'll see if it works. Yes, it did. There we go. So it's already asking me to set it up. So I will. Yes, I'll have English. Touchscreen interface on the screen. English. Next. Lisbon, London, GMT. Yes. Set to summertime. I'm going to tentatively click on yes. Set date and time display mode. I want day, month, year. Because that's how you should do it. So I will do most of this off camera, and then I'll jump back in when it's all set up properly.
But first, a word from our sponsor.
I don't bloody believe it. None of the footage was recorded properly. Did I not? Did I not put the bloody card in properly or something? Oh God. Oh, now I'm just depressed.
Hey there, you sir.
Hello?
Yes, you. Are you feeling depressed?
I guess.
Then cure your depression with retail therapy here at emmablackeryshop.com.
Oh, okay. Now my depression is cured. Thanks, emmablackeryshop.com.
Warning, retail therapy does not cure depression. emmablackeryshop.com does not take responsibility. Terms and conditions apply.
Okay, well then, here we are. Out in the wild. I hope you can hear me. I've got the fluffy thing on the camera, on the microphone there. Finally cheered up enough for me to come out and test this camera. It's mighty windy, so the camera might wobble a bit and the audio might be a bit of a mess. But I'm doing the best I can. So what we're going to be doing today is just kind of having a wander around, having a bit of a play with the camera and some of the settings, and we're just going to kind of see what it can do, see what it's capable of in relatively ideal shooting conditions. And we're just going to take a look and have a play, basically. So I thought I'd start the kind of the test footage section under what I would deem ideal conditions. Wireless lav mic, camera on a tripod, in relatively decent surroundings. I'm away from the road, I'm away from most of the people, and it's nice and sunny, and there's an interesting background behind me, which you can probably hear through the microphone. So, why don't we take the camera and have a little run around and see what we can come up with. Let's go. All right, so now I'm testing the handheld kind of vlog style shot to test out how the, what's it called, steady cam, the gimbal thing works. Still super wild to see this thing wiggling around in my face. It's really weird. But I guess the plus side of that is, well, A, it makes a shot steady, or steadier, and it also helps with keeping my attention on the lens, which is where I should be looking when filming, really. Fun fact, I used to stick a little picture of myself just above the lens of my old camera to try and keep my attention at the lens rather than the screen, which didn't work at all. But at least this time I've got the weird wiggly lens to look at, which is extremely amusing. So let's keep testing, shall we? There's an alarm over there. It wasn't me what did it. Okay, here we go then. Testing the zoom on a flag that's not blowing in the wind anymore. There we go. And also testing the capability of the zoom. Zoom? I've said that. The Steadicam shot too. All right, now it's a front-facing test. Hello, there appears to be some Easter goings on up here. It is Good Friday today, after all. Let's see if I can get that. Dunna, 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 dunna. Oh, hey, that's mighty impressive. That says words. I can't see what it says, but it says words on the top. I don't know. There's a fair few people up there as well. Blimey. Let's have a look at the sea. What can we see? Jokes. Nothing. No boats to film. Why do I live here? How dull. Ooh, look at me. Doing an arty shot. I'm doing a walk. I'm walking. I'm doing a good old walk. Like a student film piece of shit. It's a nice day, actually. Let's do a pan round, shall we? Wow. I don't know if you can see that. Because the screen's too bright. Too bright? The sun's too bright on the screen. This is going to be fun to edit. Hopefully the camera knows what it's doing. I've left it all in automatic mode, so it should be, but what do I know? Okay, I have spotted and boat. Where's it gone? There it is. I do not believe that I'll be able to see it through the screen, but I will try. Cannot see. Is that it? There it is. I found it. Again, should be on a tripod, but there's a boat. Look at that. Whee! Hey, that's not bad for a handheld shot, if I do say so myself. Humble brag. It's not great either, I'll admit, but I found a boat. That means I win. I win all the internet points. Oh, look, there's a lighthouse over there. Let's zoom in on that. Where'd it be, Adam? Where'd it go? There it is. Wow, hello, lighthouse. Used to be a chapel. Family of 16 lived there. Fun facts no one cares about. Where'd you go? Wait, come here. Smile. Yeah. Beat your heart out, David Attenborough. Where'd it go? Come back. There you are. Oh, bloody hell. Whee! Yeah, I think I'll stick to YouTube. I don't think I want to go and work for the BBC. Ocean sounds, hopefully. Oh, look, there's my shadow. Woo! How did I never notice those steps down there before? Weird. I've come down here bloody long enough to notice. Apparently not. I spy me a flag. It's a bit caught up. It could have been unwrapped, but interesting. Getting plenty of practice with the zoom and also the steady shot thing as well, which is good. Okay, so one of the final tests I want to do is I'm walking up some stairs and I'm about to go into some shadow. There we go. So on the screen, my face is completely black. That might not be the case. LCD brightness and all that. But let's walk up into the sunny bit and see if that makes any difference or when I do that. Hopefully it has. So I think for all of the talking head parts, I think it's pretty much done. So now I will catch my breath and get some fancy B-roll shots of, I don't know, flowers and shit. I don't know.
Memories like voices that call on the wind. Mevel and Quinns, whispered and tossed on the tide coming in. Mevel, oh Mevel and Quinns. Voices like songs that are heard in the dawn. Mevel and Quinns, singing the secrets of children unborn. Mevel, oh Mevel and Quinns. Dreams like the memories once born on the wind. Mevel and Quinns, lovers and children and copper and tin. Mevel, oh Mevel and Quinns. Dreams like the castles that sleep in the sand. Mevel and Quinns, slip through the fingers or held in. Mevel, oh Mevel and Quinns. Songs like the dreams that the bow made and spin. Mevel and Quinns, weaving the song of the cry of the tin.
Okay, so a couple of things I've noticed. First of all, the Zoom is unbelievably quiet. And it's extremely weird feeling the little lens there bobbing around in its bath of oil there on the gimbal. It's extremely spooky and kind of freaks you out if you're not expecting it. And there's people looking at me like I'm weird. But genuinely, I mean, okay, I haven't had much experience playing with cameras of this caliber, but now that I have, you know what? It's pretty damn good. It's not half bad. Much better than the piece of garbage I was using before, the Canon 200D. It's a good camera. It's just, I mean, it's a DSLR, so it's limited to 30 minutes recording time in one go. But the 60 frames per second is tasty. And as I've mentioned before, I would have preferred that with this camera. 4K 60 makes more sense than 4K 30, or actually 24 in this case. But overall, it's a damn impressive camera. I've got the tripod stuck on a fence. What the f- Wow. I'm so clever. I think I'm going to be pretty impressed with this camera. It seems fairly capable, and for the price, which I will say now, was £699 from Amazon. It's a lot of money. I would have preferred 60 frames per second as well, ideally, but I know that's not always possible with a camera like this. Especially the selling it on the budget they did, so I can forgive them for that. Other than that though, I think it's top notch. So, yeah. We likey. Good job, Sony. Let's throw this into the editor and see what kind of video I can make. Thank you very much for watching, and goodbye.